We're here with Buddy McGurk at his gym. Of course, Kenny, I want to ask you really quick. Mike Tyson, Roy Jones, I heard they're going to say no knockout. Is that possible to have a sparring or an exhibition with no headgear, small gloves, and no knockout?
Small gloves, not big gloves. Those are big gloves. They say big gloves.
12 ounces is pretty small for a heavyweight. Maybe even 10. What do you think of the fight?
Fight, if they have on 12 ounces and you haven't been hit in a few years, they're gonna feel like 2 ounces.
Yeah. That'll be like 14, that'll be 12.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, and no headgear?
No headgear.
No headgear, right?
No headgear. No headgear. The reason I think it's exhibition, because this way it doesn't have to get sanctioned and they can make it happen. Because if it was sanctioned, they would be scrutinized for the age, for the inactivity.
Yeah.
They want to get in there and mix up. Mike Tyson in great shape, Roy is in great shape. It's going to be a good fight.
Yeah. I agree, that's just
$50.
I'm going to see Tyson tomorrow, so I'm going to take him. He in good shape, but Tyson, I don't know Roy Jones. I know Roy Jones is good, but
yeah.
I don't know if he's in shape. I know Tyson's in shape, but it's a different shape.
Well, Tyson is rejuvenated. He looks happy. Roy. Okay, let me ask you guys this. If this fight happened 15 years ago, what would you guys think then?
Mike.
Mike all the way.
Why?
15 years ago.
Roy was moving like a cobra.
Mike with Kevin Rooney. He has Kevin Rooney. Mike. Kevin just knew what switches to hit with Mike.
I talked to Ronnie Shields yesterday. I said, what's the one thing that surprised you the most about Mike Tyson when you coach him? You know what he told me? How much tape he watches, that he was watching Jack Johnson. Every time he was around Mike, he was watching boxing. Do you guys have fighters like that eat, sleep, and drink boxing?
Nope.
Why not?
Not nowadays. I don't. I wish they did. I know I did. I know Buddy did.
Most fighters today are too busy on Instagram.
That's what I'm saying.
What fighters do you guys recommend people to watch? If a young and upcoming fighter is watching this video, who would you recommend them to watch to work on defense, to work on footwork, to work on throwing the hook, the body shot?
I mean, just look on the wall here, baby.
Okay, who do you have on the wall? Break it down, buddy. That's Roberto Duran, right?
Roberto Duran.
He looks like a soap opera star in that.
I know, exactly. And above Roberto Duran is going to be going for Pernell Whitaker.
Yes.
I mean, then you got James Toney.
The one and only.
You got Hector Lopez, Ezra Charles, Arturo, Bernard Hopkins, Marvin Hagler, Joe Lewis, Henry Armstrong, Jack Johnson, Archie Moore, Salvador Sanchez.
I see Buddy McGurk. I see Buddy McGurk. What fight of yours should they watch, Buddy?
Joe Frazier, and you got Jersey Joe Walcott. If you can't learn from watching them, then you don't want to learn.
Go get a job.
Exactly.
If you ever had to tell a fighter, hey, boxing is not for you, get a job?
You know what? I sit them down and be like, listen, man, you have any other things in life you want to do? Now, I'm a realist with guys, man, you know.
It's dangerous.
I just tell them to do it for a hobby, not real, just work out. That's all.
And what's their response? Oh, screw you, I'm going to go to a trainer that
you
will
know
make
me.
How
many people have heard that from, man? Man, the hell with you. Okay, no problem. Listen, anybody can beat the heavy bag. Anybody can beat up the mitts. When you get in that ring and the bell rings, it's a whole different ballgame, man.
You ever watch American Idol when they try out and the guy says, hey, you're not, it's not for you.
Yeah.
Well, I'll show you.
How Tyson say, everybody got a plan till they get hit.
Exactly. Once you get hit, that shit go out the window. The longest walk in the world is from the dressing room to the ring. It seems like you're never going to get there.